My friend, we have traveled very far. We have no food, no water. Once I see my people fed, I would be honored.
No. We have a serious problem with radical Islam. We have a tremendous problem. And we can't be the stupid country anymore.
Where I come from, guests are treated with respect, not insulted at the gates.
Oh, hello. Hello.
You know, it's amazing. I mentioned food stamps, and that guy who's seriously overweight went crazy. He went crazy.
Me interviewing me, that's what I call a great idea.
Of course it's a great idea. We thought of it.
As long as you don't start talking over me when I'm trying to make a point.
Yeah, question one. You recently said, quote, Mr. Trump insults and dismisses women. But tell me, what would you do to help women in this country?
You know, Donald, I've spent my entire career fighting for women's rights. I'll push for equal pay in the workplace, for protecting women's health and reproductive rights, making quality, affordable childcare a reality for families. That's what I believe in. That's what I'm fighting for. You know, I'm really curious, Donald. What is your stance on women's issues?
Look, I know a lot of women, and they all have issues.
Donald Trump is a businessman, real estate developer, and mogul. But more than that, he is a brand, and that brand is larger than life. The Donald has brought his gold touch to a lot of different products.
I've got some business idea that I just want to tell you about, and I'll be a fool if...
Very quickly.
Our fave? Not the books, the buildings, or the booze. It's the board game.
My new game is Trump, the game.
Trump, the game, where you deal for everything you ever wanted to own.
Whether it's vodka, an airline, hotels, or casinos, if it's Trump, you can be sure it's tacky.
Because it's not whether you win or lose, it's whether you win.
Yes!
Play Trump, the game. From Milton Bradley.
I think you'll like it.
Given the circumstances, my lord, I believe extreme measures are warranted.
The people that are with me 100% are the people.
What?
The Pope. The Pope was in Mexico. Do you know that? Did Desiree know, right? He said negative things about me.
Dreadful.
The Pope is being told that Donald Trump is not a nice person. Donald Trump is a very nice person.
You do not let us in. All of us will die.
I said temporarily. I didn't say permanently. I said temporarily.
We have no border. We have no control. People are flooding across. We need to build a wall. And it has to be built quickly.
The greatest builder is me. And I would build the greatest wall you have ever seen.
And in that wall, we're going to have a beautiful, big, fat door where people can come into the country, but they have to come in legally.
I don't think they like me very much.
This country needs somebody that's a deal maker.
I'm giving you Commander Greyguard.
No deals. No deals. We don't make deals. Not with anybody. We don't make deals.
You mistake me, my lord. That was a command.
No. Excuse me. Just so you understand. We need people that know what they're doing. We don't need babies.
Are you refusing to obey my order?
Yeah. By the way, I think you could say that, yeah.
Ollie, bring me my sword.
They laugh at us. Our enemies laugh at us. But they say, what about it? And they chop off heads. They think we are so stupid. You have no idea.
Much liked my head. I don't want to see it removed just yet.
Nobody in Congress likes him. Nobody likes him anywhere once they get to know him.
Okay, so no one likes Ted Cruz. Mr. Trump, a rebuttal.
I really do. I'd like Ted Cruz a lot.
Okay. All right. Right out of the gate, there's a strong difference of opinion between our one candidate. Okay, the next question is for you, Donald. How do you feel about the people of Iowa and your chances with them?
I love Iowa. We've done really well here.
All right. Fairly stated. Mr. Trump, your thoughts.
How stupid are the people of Iowa?
I actually got inside early while I was waiting for it to start. I listened to these like four guys in the row behind me. This one guy in particular was saying, he kept referring to this one Indian teenager further down the row as ISIS. And the kid was hearing him say these awful racial slurs. The teenager snaps and says, hey, f*** you. And then the idiot sicks the cops on this Indian teenager, and they take him aside and intimidate him. Some of the things the dudes behind me said, kill all Muslims, I wish I had my peace on me, dude, I want to shoot someone so bad. And the thing Trump's really good at is getting otherwise rational people to clamp down harder on their fears and prejudices. These people aren't monsters. They're completely normal, but for whatever reason, they let their fears drive them, and that turns them into...
I watch as politicians are trying to claim that, and that's okay with me. You know, they're all talk, no action, so they won't do anything anyway, just so you understand.
I've watched the politicians. I've dealt with them all my life. They will never make America great again. They don't even have a chance. They're controlled fully by the lobbyists, by the donors, and by the special interests. These politicians, they run and they run and they win and sometimes they lose and they keep running. That's all they do is run. Most of them don't know what they're doing. They just keep run. I just hate to see when people don't have common sense, don't have an understanding of what's going on, or perhaps don't want to know. Maybe it's campaign contributions, maybe it's special interests, maybe it's lobbyists. But for some reason, some people don't get it, and I don't think they'll be in office much longer. I really mean that.
How are you going to create jobs in this country?
I'm just going to do it.
We have very stupid people in our country negotiating for us, and we have leaders that don't know what they're doing.
I respect Mexico, but their leaders are too smart for our leaders, because we have stupid leaders, okay?
You know, free trade, I believe in it. Totally. I'm a free trader. The problem with free trade is you need smart people on our side. When you don't have smart people, free trade is not a good thing. Free trade can be wonderful if you have smart people.
We will find out on Monday. Now, gentlemen, if either of you win this nomination, you're likely to go up against Hillary Clinton. How do you assess her foreign policy experience?
Hillary Clinton was the worst Secretary of State in the history of the United States.
Worst in history? Huh. Mr. Trump, your thoughts.
Hillary Clinton, I think, is a terrific woman. I mean, I'm a little biased because I've known her for years. I think she really works hard, and I think she does a good job, and I like her.
That is a strong endorsement of Hillary Clinton from Donald Trump. That's got to hurt her in the polls.
But we have people that are stupid. We have people that aren't smart, and we have people that are controlled by special interests, and it's just not going to work.
You can win against China if you're smart. But our people don't have a clue. We give state dinners to the heads of China. I say, why are you doing state dinners for them? They're ripping us left and right. Just take them to McDonald's and go back to the negotiating table. Seriously.
Next question. How do you plan to get your message across to the American people?
Well, look, Donald, it's a long campaign, and traveling across our great nation, I'm listening to people's stories. I'm confident Americans will see I can deliver for them, that they can count on me for them and their families.
See? You sound like a robot. Bleep, lorp, does not compute.
Now, for this next portion of the debate, we're going to go and take questions from everyday Americans who are watching. Our first one comes from a Megan K, who lives in 2011. Megan, what is your question?
Do you really think that you're a better moderator than I am?
No, I could never beat you. That wouldn't even be close. There would be no contest. You have done a great job, by the way, and I mean it.
That's a very positive message. How about you, Donald?
I have zero respect for Megyn Kelly. I don't think she's very good at what she does. I think she's highly overrated.
Now, I must warn you, sir. I must warn you to be careful, Mr. Trump. In the past, when you've turned against a woman that way, she ends up with half your assets. Now, Donald, if you yourself are elected, who can we expect to see in your cabinet?
We're going to have the smartest, the best negotiators in the world, and I know most of them. And believe me, I know people you never heard of who are better than the ones that you did hear of.